Hey, what's up, everybody? Solo Wolf here, and right now I'm going to be giving you guys a quick rundown on how to make some parkour courses with the Parkour Palace plugin. So we're going to go ahead and start off by placing a sign that we're going to be using for this course's course sign, and you can use colors with the and sign and then a number. You look up bucket colors if you want to know exactly how to use them. I'm going to go ahead and set this course sign to 6. And then you use @C for the course name. This one was not made by me. If it was made by me, I could just use @P instead of typing my name in and put it there. But this one was actually made by Claire Thomas, so we're going to go ahead and give her credit for that. And then the other things you can use are @ L and @ V. Or @ L and @ I. @ L is for course lives, which is what we're putting here, and @ I is course time if you're going to be using course timers. We're not on this one. The leader sign follows pretty much the exact same format. We're not going to be using a leader sign though, because we're not using time for this courses or for this course. But go ahead and show you how this works. So first thing you need to do is start creating one. Default command is pp create and then the course name. This course is called the North Pole. So pp create North Pole brings up this menu. Use course timer, use lives, and use vanish box. Now we're not using course timer. We are going to use lives, so we go ahead and left click on that and to turn it on, and we're actually going to shift left click to take it up to 30 lives. You shift right click to take it down, and then use vanish blocks. You left click to turn on, right click to turn off. We're not going to use vanish blocks for this one, but if you do use them, after you close the menu by hitting escape, it'll bring up another menu like this one where it has all the blocks that you can vanish listed. You set that up in your config file and you use it the same way, left click to turn on, right click to turn off, and shift left click to take how many seconds it takes for them to vanish up, shift right click to take it down. Anyway, you exit out of that and it saves that. So then we're going to go ahead and set our course sign here, pp set c sign. As you can see, it automatically fills in the name, number of lives that have on it, and everything. Then we've got some locations we need to set. First is our lobby location, which for us we always set right here. Default command for that is s lobby. In location, we always just set it at the next course in line, so pp s end to set the end location. And we'll go ahead and go set the start location for the North Pole, which is going to be pp s start. Hey. Then we can go ahead and start adding checkpoints in. Now for this first checkpoint, we're actually going to give them a timer but not a potion effect. Now to do that, it's pp add checkpoint by default. I keep saying by default because you can change all this stuff in your config to be whatever you want it to be. So we do pp add cp for add checkpoint, and then this one is not going to have potion effects, so we put that false. It is going to have a timer, so we put that true. We're going to give them 30 seconds to complete this, and the timer is completed by stepping on a gold block. Now if they don't step on a gold block within 30 seconds, it'll teleport them back to that checkpoint now. But there's a gold block right here for them to get to in 30 seconds. I'm going to go ahead and come down here, set our next checkpoint. This one we are going to give a potion effect. We are not going to use a timer. And this one we're just going to kind of troll with a potion effect. We're going to give them a slow potion for 2 seconds with a strength of 2, just to make sure when they first come on this checkpoint they're probably going to miss the jump. Okay. For our next one, we'll go ahead and give them a timer and a potion effect, so you can see how that format works real quick. So, add checkpoint, true for potion effect, true for timer. Now the timer goes first. So for this one, we're going to give them 90 seconds to finish it. The timer will be ended by stepping on a not diamond, but a diamond block. And then we're going to give them a speed effect for the full 90 seconds at a strength of 2. And for the rest of our checkpoints, we'll go ahead and just set everything to false to get through it real quick. As you can see from the length of this course, this is why I didn't use a total course timer for it. I might go back in and edit that later, put like 5 or 6 minutes on it, just so there is one. Because people love leaderboards. Anyway, then you set your end block. Now the start and end blocks, they right click to use. So PP set end. We have set the end block for the course now as this gold block. And the only thing we haven't done is to set bad blocks, which we use carpet. And you use add bad or remove bad to add and remove blocks from the list of bad blocks. And bad blocks, of course, are the blocks that if they touch, it will send them back to their last checkpoint. If you're using lives and they run out of lives, it'll send them back to the start. And that's pretty much all it is to set these up. There are a bunch of options in the config and in the locale settings that you can go through and mess with and really customize the plugin to your own use. As you can see, this course down here, we've got wool as vanishing blocks, so as Ginger's going through, the blocks are disappearing behind him, dropping him to his death. And the plugin really doesn't lag at all. It's made really well with some good timers to where it keeps everything flowing good. So now the only thing we have left to do is toggle to activate the course, and then PP save to save it. The course saved, and edit mode has been disabled. And then you can go ahead and play it. Now it will lock the course order. So since this is our first course, players have to beat this one before they can go onto this one. And then they do this one, and then they do this one in that order. When they right click on it, it puts them in the start position. They can go through, play their courses however they want. If they mess up, it will send them back. If they don't mess up, they can get to the end block. And we're gonna go ahead and just do this first course here real quick to see how badly I can mess up. Apparently pretty badly. I can tell you, these small jumps with a speed boost are not fun. Especially with disappearing blocks underneath you. Stone block ends the effect. Next checkpoint. Ooh. And that is my last life, so I better not fall again if I actually want to make it to the end here. Oh, and I didn't jump, so I missed the end block. Just so this video doesn't go on, I'm going to go ahead and fly up to this end block. Show you what happens. So they jump, they hit the end block. You have completed Palace Steps. Your progress has been saved. You have completed Palace Steps in 69 seconds. That's your best time yet. It will keep track of best times. When players make best times, it will be on here. That one currently says I'm the course leader with 38 because that is my actual best time, but I reset the files recently while doing some testing. Now that is a full rundown on exactly how you set up a course with the Parkour Palace plugin. If you guys have any questions, feel free to shoot me a message on BucketDev, or go ahead and hop on play.versuscraft.com to let me type this in here. Go ahead and log on to the thing that I can't type right. play.versuscraft.com, and you can check out the Parkour Palace that we have set up here, see how the plugin works firsthand, or even hop on and possibly catch me online and ask me questions right on here. Thank you guys very much for watching. You have a great day.